Hello, class 9th. Hope you all are good. Now, children, today we will continue the same chapter number 5, periodic table. Let's start the chapter, periodic table. As you all know that periods are 7 horizontal rows of elements arranged in increasing order of atomic number in modern periodic table, right? And period number signify what? Number of electron shells of an element. अब सपोज इफ क्वेश्चन इज देयर कि सपोज एन एलिमेंट हैविंग एटॉमिक नंबर 19 एंड मास नंबर 39, राइट? देन नेचुरली इफ एटॉमिक नंबर इज 19 तो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर आल्सो 19, व्हाट्स इट वुड इट्स इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन 2, देन 8, 8 एंड 1, राइट? दिस योर व्हाट दिस इज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन ऑफ एन एलिमेंट एक्स. Now, then what would be its valency? Its valency would be what? What it will do to get a stable electronic configuration? It will lose this one electron. So, its valency is plus 1, right? It would be metal, non-metal or noble gas? It would be metal. Why? Because metals always lose the electron and they have positive valency, right? Now, okay, it's metal. Now, question is, this element occupy which position in periodic table? In which period it would be? Because period number signify number of shells. How many shells are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, which period it will come? It will come in fourth period, right? And in which group it will come? Group number signify valency electron, which all of you know the last the electron present in the last shell or valency shell is called valency electron. So how many valency electrons are there? That is 1. So it will come in first group. Understood, right? Let's take another example. Suppose why an atom of an element whose atomic number is 35. How many electrons are there? It means 35 electrons are there. Electronic configuration 2, 8, 18, 7. So, what would be its valency? Its valency would be what? It will, to get a stable electronic configuration, it will gain 1 electron. So, its valency is minus 1. Right? And metal, non-metal or noble gas? It would be non-metal. Why? Because non-metals always gain the what? They gain electrons. And now what would what's its position in the periodic table? In which period it would be? It would be just you will count the number of shell. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 shell are there. So period number is 4. Fourth period. And group number signify valency electron. How many valency electron is here? 7. So it will come in 17th group. Which group? 17th group. Just remember, if last electron, if in last shell the electron number is 1, so it will come in first group. If 2 is here, then it will come in second group, right? If it is 3 electrons are there in the last shell, then it will come in 13th group. You will add 10 plus and then it will come in 13th group. If 4 is here, then 14th group. If 5 is here, then it is come in 15th group. Right? These are what? Okay. If 5 valency electron is here, then 15. 6 valency electron is here, it will come in 16th group. If 7 electrons are there, then it will come in 17th group, right? And if 8 electrons are there, how many electrons? If 8 electrons is valency electron are 8, then number of in which group it would be? It would be in 18th group or 0 group. Which group? 18th group or 0 group. Understood? Next is what are the property trends of elements from left to right in a period? The property trends are that number of electron shell always remains same. Number of shells always remain same. Just look at here, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, all are having 3 shells. So number of shells remain what? Same. And valency electron, it increases by 1. Just see valency electron of sodium, 1. This is the second, which period is this? Period number 3. Okay. Magnesium, it become valency electron become 2. Then in aluminium, valency electron become 3, then 4, then 5, then 6, then 7, and then argon, 8. Means valency electron increases by 1. So there is a transition from metallic to non-metallic character. First in the starting, there are metals, then metalloids, okay, and then non-metals. So name the metalloid present in period 3, that is your silicon. Okay, you have to learn this, these elements, especially of period 1, period 2 and period 3 elements, right, with their atomic numbers. Okay, in previous video, I had already explained about you about the groups, but group number signify what? Number of valency electrons of an element. Right, in first group, one valency electron, second valency electron. And so first group elements are called alkali metals, second group elements are called alkaline earth metals, third 3 to 12 are called transition elements, and then 13 to 16 are called post transition elements, and 17 group elements are called halogens, and 18 group elements are called what? Noble gases or inert gases. Okay, now what is the property trends of elements on moving from down in a subgroup? When you move down in a group, then what's the property trends of elements? Now, what is valency electron remains same. Just look at here. Lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, they all have belong to the same first group. Okay, and what they are called? Alkali metals. So, what is same? The valency electron is same. One, here is lithium also having one, then sodium also valency electron one, potassium also one, rubidium also one, and cesium also one. And chemical properties, all of you know that they depend on what? Valency electron or electronic configuration. So, well, that's why the chemical properties of all these elements is always same. It remain similar. Or if some changes are there, these changes are gradually changes are there, right? Second, what the transition takes place from when you move from top to bottom? Okay, number of electron shells increases by 1. Just see, lithium only 2 shell, sodium 3 shell, potassium 4 shell, and rubidium how many? 5 shells. Then cesium 6 shells, right? So, what transition takes place when you move down in a group? A number of electron shares increases by 1, and metallic character increases down a subgroup. Now, your question is, write short notes on alkali metals, alkaline earth metals. So, what are alkali metals? Alkali metals are present in group 1 of the modern periodic table, and when they react with when they react with water, they form strong alkali. That is why they are called alkali metals. Why group 1 elements are called alkali metals? Because when they react with water, they form strong alkali. Understood? Now, the elements of this alkali metals are light metals, right? And third point, alkali metals are strong reducing agents, and elements are highly reactive. The alkali metals are highly reactive. They are electropositive metals. But they are highly reactive and electropositive matters, which are soft and can cut with knife. Especially this sodium and potassium can cut with knife. Name two matters which can cut with knife. That is your sodium, right, and potassium. And they are good conductor of heat and electricity. And they form electrovalent compounds with non-metals. When they react with chlorine or bromine, they form electrovalent compounds. So, just you learn these main 4 points of alkali metals. Next is your alkaline earth metals. They are present in group 2. Group 2 elements are called alkaline earth metals. Why they are called alkaline earth metals? Because when they form weak alkali when react with water. Why they are called alkaline earth metal? Because they form weak alkali when they react with water. and alkaline earth metals are light metals, right? And alkaline earth metals, they have properties similar, they are slightly less reactive than alkali metals. So these 3 points you write in alkaline earth metals. Third point is your alkaline earth metals are less reactive than alkali metals, right? Now next is your halogens. Halogens are present in group 17, or 17 group elements are also called halogens. Why they are called halogens? Just because halogen means salt producer. Hal means salt and gen means producer. Since they react with matters to form salt, that is why they are called halogens. Why group 17 elements are called halogens? Because they are salt producer. Right? When they react with matters, they form salt. And that is why they are called halogens. Halo means salt and gen means producer. And the most reactive halogen is fluorine. And the most abundant for halogen is chlorine. Abundant means which is found in large quantity. Right? Now next second third point is your halogens are strong oxidizing agents, right? And the elements of this 17 group elements or halogens are highly reactive, right? And they form what type of compounds? Covalent compounds when they react with non metals. Okay, now next is your just one more thing is here, halogens or they all are diatomic. All of you know how to write chlorine, Cl2, bromine, Br2, fluorine, F2, and iodine, I2, because they are diatomic, atom. Their atomicity is 2, right? Now, one more thing, just name two halogens which are found in gaseous state. These are chlorine and fluorine, right? And name the halogen found in liquid state, that is your bromine is the only halogen which is found in liquid state. Name the halogen found in solid state, that is your iodine, right? Now next is your noble gases. They are noble gases are 18 group elements are called noble gases in modern periodic table. The elements, group 18 elements have 8 valency electron in their outermost shell except helium, which has what? 2 electron. Has only 2 electron in the last shell. Valency or combining capacity of noble gases is 0. Why? Because they have stable electronic configuration. Okay, and that is why noble gases, they do not react with other elements and therefore they are also known, they are called inert or unreactive elements. And they all are monoatomic gases. Right? And children, learn these period elements of period 2 and period 3. Period 1, to, all of you know, that is hydrogen and helium. And in period 2 is your 8 elements, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon. And carbon is, boron is a metalloid of period 2. Same way, silicon is a metalloid of period 4. Name the alkaline earth metal of period 2. That is your, what? Alkaline earth metal is beryllium. So, just learn these one. Okay? Learn these elements of period 2 and 3 by heart. Okay, thank you, children.